to Sharon Ray with your Doppler 10 weather forecast.
Well, good afternoon. As we head through August, we see the biggest increase in tropical activity normally. In fact, this is the time of year we tend to see that peak of tropical activity around September 10th. And it has been becoming more active out there. We have this potential tropical cyclone 6, which is likely to be Fred tonight. Meanwhile, we're also watching a disturbance out here, which has a low chance of development. But it's this system that we're keeping a close eye on because it is expected to develop further. And as it does, it is expected to move across the Dominican Republic tonight. It's moving south of Puerto Rico right now, still just with those 35 mile an hour winds, but is likely to strengthen a little bit before it weakens as it rides over the islands here, as it tracks to the west northwest over just to the north of Cuba, and then strengthen again as it gets into the Gulf. Forecast models are giving it a northern turn, and that would take it closer to Florida by later in the weekend, and it may strengthen too. So something that we'll be keeping an eye on in coming days. Meanwhile, back at home, it's sunny and it's hot. Nothing much happening here in our weather. You can see we've got 94 right now at Beeville and feeling like 109 with that humidity out there right now. Lots of blue sky in Kingsville right now. 94 degrees at this hour and plenty of blue sky as well in Corpus Christi as that temperature is up to 92. Feeling like 102. As we go through the next few hours, though, we'll see those temperatures coming down this evening, but it's going to stay warm again tonight in the 80s much of the night. If you're planning on being out and about this evening, perhaps taking a walk or just taking the dog out for a walk this evening or enjoying the cooling air, you can check the western sky low on the horizon, a very bright planet, but it's low. That's Venus. Our crescent moon to the right of that planet tonight will gradually be rising higher in the sky each night this week. And that waxing crescent moon by Thursday night continuing to climb past and moving past the bright star Spica. At the same time, we have the Perseid meteor shower going on and it's peaking. It's possible if you're in a very dark location and you're patient, you could see 60 to 70 meteors per hour from this. You want to look in the night sky. Best time is after midnight and in a dark location. All right, as far as rain, none out there right now. It's all staying out over the Gulf, these little streamer showers heading to the north. However, by later in the week, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, there may be a few of these moving in as tropical moisture will be increasing. For now, it still looks dry. And tomorrow, hot and dry, lots of sunshine tomorrow. And that breeze picking up a little bit, not as windy though tomorrow. Winds up to about 15 to 18 miles an hour, just a bit breezy. And those feels like temperatures climbing. Here are the forecast highs for tomorrow. The average high this time of year, as we're in the hottest time of the summer, is 96. I expect 94 Corpus Christi to 97 at Robstown tomorrow. It's going to be a steamy day, and that feels like temperature climbing from 105 to 110 each day this week. We're going to be dealing with that. Winds are coming down. They're going to be much lighter. That'll allow nights to cool a bit more. We'll see those nights dropping into the mid to upper 70s later this week. Meanwhile, our dome of high pressure is over us. There's no rain in the area, but you see, this is the water vapor satellite right here. You see this water vapor increasing here. This is moving toward us, and that, as it moves in with a little wave of low pressure, will increase our rain chance just slightly for later this week and the weekend. But still lots of dry time to get outdoors. Here's your 7-day forecast, and a lot of heat too. As you can see, those heat indices each day, 105 to 110, and daytime highs in the low to mid 90s. Paul?
All right. We're good.